What's up, YouTube? It's Paparazzi. I'm back with another video. Oops, I just hit my mic. And today we're going to be talking about Bitcoin, and we're going to talk about Dogecoin, mostly Dogecoin. So, like I said in my last video, Dogecoin is on its way up. And it was being sold for so little back in the days. The price was 0.007. When I got into it, it was 0.008. So that was quick. It happened so quick, I can't even pinpointed on this chart here because this is the month. And within that time frame, January 28th, somewhere around there, I got into it. And let's say right here, when it hits 7 cents, which is almost 10 times as much as I put into it, this is January 29th. So from January 28th to January 29th, there's a huge spike. And that's only one day. So that's the thing to know about cryptocurrency. If you've ever been looking at stocks years back, stocks is slow. Stocks has an open and closed market, and you don't know what exactly is going to happen or what is happening when the market is closed. So you have to kind of pray that when the market opens up that you have more money than you invested. But with cryptocurrency, is always live. It's always happening. You can buy this second, and then your purchase will go through with a stock. If you buy during the close hours, then it won't go through until the market opens. And then also whatever you sell for, let's say you buy a stock for $100 and then the market's closed and you want to get rid of that stock to go put it into something else, that sale won't go through until the market opens. And if it opens and it's at $90, then you lost $10 and you sold it for, you know, $90. Or if it went up to $200, you might have, you know, got an extra $100, but you don't know. You have no idea. You can't really relocate your funds, reallocate your funds, if you don't know what the price is of your stock. But with cryptocurrency, you know what the price is always. It's always live. You can see it online, and you can buy and sell it at a moment's notice. It really depends how fast it goes based on whether you use a credit card, whether you use an app, whether you use your bank account. There's different things that will slow it down, but for the most part, you can buy and sell it within the hour rather than having to wait for an entire day. Or I think the market for the stocks are even closed on the weekends. I don't know a whole lot about stocks because, you know, I don't want to deal with that. It's too slow for me. And like I said in my other video, or maybe I didn't say it, but I'm not a financial advisor. I am not an expert. I don't have all the answers. I'm just giving you what I know, telling you what I've researched, telling you what I've observed, and giving you information to where if you are brand new to cryptocurrency, you're brand new to investments, you're brand new to stocks or whatever, and you want to jump into it, but it's so overwhelming, you don't even know where to start, you can come watch this video. And all I'm going to do is give you some information to kind of guide you towards the right things to research. So when you're doing your research, I recommend, highly recommend that you look at big financial companies like bank accounts, and celebrities. Celebrities are a big influencer on the way things happen. If a celebrity does a shout out to a store, that store's stock is probably going to go up a little bit, depending on the influence, depending on the influence of that celebrity. So for example, Dogecoin is being shout out a lot by Elon Musk, the richest man in the world, one of the most influential people of our time right now. So when he talks about Dogecoin, whether it's a joke, whether it's serious, he can just say the word Dogecoin and the price will not skyrocket. The price will go up, guaranteed. It's happened almost every single time. So I would definitely check into his Twitter account and just see what he's talking about. He tweets like every day. And whenever he says anything big about Dogecoin, the price goes up. The bigger it is, the bigger the comment is, the bigger the fluctuation of the Dogecoin. Again, I'm not an expert. I'm just going off of what I've seen. I'm going off of the past. These things have been proven to have happened in the past. So I can only project and guess, I guess, the future based on what happened in the past. So lately he's been talking about Dogecoin, and he put $1.5 billion into Bitcoin. So that immediately went up by $4,000. Immediately. So what I'm saying, as far as the celebrities talking about things having an influence on the movement of these cryptocurrencies is true. So definitely check out these celebrities. Go to Twitter and see who's talking about Dogecoin. Maybe hashtag Dogecoin and look that up and see who's talking about it. And the more people who talk about it, the more the price is going to go up. The more people who buy into it, the more the price is going to go up. It started off as a joke, but it's serious now. And you can still take it as a joke and maybe it will crash. Maybe it's a bubble. A lot of people like to say it's a bubble. People who are afraid to invest in it will say it's a bubble, it's going to pop. But whether it's a bubble or not, you know, you can still ride the wave until you feel like it's going to crash and then get out. You don't have to stay in it forever. I definitely recommend doing some research, looking into it, and seeing what you want to do and what kind of money that you are willing to put into an investment. Because when you invest your money, you have to treat it like your money's already gone. So if I invest $100, I'm thinking to myself that $100 is already gone. I don't own that money anymore. It's all just a number on the computer now. I don't own it. I can't spend it. I can't go out and buy a meal with that $100 anymore. It's no longer mine. Until I pull out that money, and hopefully that money will be more like $200, $300, whatever. But like I said here, when I got into it, it was 008 cents. And if I would have put $100 into it then, that would have been $1,000 about a couple days later. So you can make some money off of this, that is for sure. And you can also lose some money. So it's not guaranteed, but it's only, what, about 6.5 cents right now. So you can literally buy one Dogecoin for six and a half cents. And then if that hits a dollar, you just made yourself a dollar, 95, 94 cents or whatever. But all I'm saying is do your research, go look at it. If you're getting into cryptocurrency, I know the COVID thing, everybody's sitting at home. Nobody can go out and drink. There's a lot of money that's not being spent. A lot of people who like to drink usually spend a good $100 a weekend on drinks with their friends and driving and gas and blah, blah, blah. But now you can use that same amount of money or even half of that money and invest it into something. Doesn't have to be Doge, doesn't have to be the Bitcoin, doesn't have to be a stock. Invest it into something and watch your money grow. When you go to the clubs, when you go to the bars, when you go out with your friends driving around and spending gas money, you don't get that money back. It's gone. It's gone for good. So definitely do some kind of investments, whether crypto, whether stocks, whether investing in yourself. And I definitely, now that is something I can really say that I'm an expert at. I can't tell you exactly if Dogecoin is going to go up or down. I can't tell you if Bitcoin is going to go up and down. But I can tell you that if you invest in yourself, that you will be profitable. Maybe not financially. You may lose your money investing in yourself. But at the end of the day, you'll be able to look yourself in the eyes and say that I tried to make a better me. So, you know, at least do that. At least invest in yourself, if nothing else. But that's all I got to say about Doge. I don't know if I mentioned it, but Doge hit 5.8 cents today. And within an hour, went right back up to 6.7 cents. So in that quick hour, you could have made a lot of money. So just watch it. It's only six, seven cents. It's definitely worth putting something into it. $5, you can get a bunch of coins with just that much money. And then make some money on top of that if you just ride these waves. And then use your money that you've gotten back. So for example, you put in $10. And then you got $20 back. Put that $10 that you initially invested in, put that away. Use that $10 that you've won or gained or whatever, profited, and then use that to buy more coins and then see if that goes up. If it goes up to $30, then you can hold all that $30 and invest that or put another $10 away. And all that money you're putting away, staying away. So even if this bubble crashes, you still have all that money that you put away. So definitely be smart about your investments. Don't just go throwing all your money into it saying, hey, Elon Musk said it's going to go up, so it has to go up. That's not always true, but it is a good indicator when a celebrity talks about it, whether something is going to go up or down. So anyways, do your research. That's all I got to say about Dogecoin. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. I'll keep you guys updated. If things spike again, I'll let you guys know. Let you guys know what I'm doing with it. And yeah. But oh yeah, one more thing. When it went to 5.8, a lot of people who bought in for 7 cents, I know a lot of people got into it around that point, probably sold a lot of Doge thinking, oh, well, this is not happening anymore. This is not the thing anymore. I need to sell before I lose too much money. Now that might have made it go down, but what I did was when it went down to 5.8, instead of selling what I bought at, because I bought some at 7 cents as well, I didn't sell that amount. I kept hold of that. When it hit 6.5, I bought more. When it hit 5.8, I bought more. And I just kept doubling down. And then when it went back to 6.7, I was able to sell and make some money. I didn't sell, not all of it. I didn't really sell any of it because it's still going to go up. For at least that's what I believe. Don't quote me on this, but I believe it's going to go up. So I held on to it. But because it kept going down, I kept buying into it. When I do sell, all those increments that I bought into it when it went down are going to be worth even more when it goes up. So sometimes you just got to double down. But again, I'm not a financial expert. I'm not a financial advisor. Do what you believe, do what you want. Just use this information as education and go somewhere else and get some more education. Do your research. Believe in your gut. And that's it. That's actually it. And I'm gonna go ahead and end the video here. But thank you for watching, and I appreciate all the support. Thank you for the almost 6.5 thousand subs, and I hope we get more. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.